But we got a couple minutes.
Okay, great. Who wants to?
Well, this was the question I posited before. The medium of Batman, right, in comics. Once you move out of comics, fans are kind of like, oh, like I'm not sure how this is going to look. Yeah. What would you say personally? What do you think fans of the comics will like about Batman?
I think that fans of Batman will obviously, some of them will be like, well, that's bullshit. We'll always get that. Or that didn't make any sense, or that would never happen. I didn't know I wanted these so much until I saw it, and I went, why is it, why doesn't DC let everybody do this? You know, as a, I know we get the Elseworlds stories, and that's great. I love to see Batman in other time periods, I love to, but they didn't even need an Elseworlds, like, excuse for this. They're just like, oh, we're just gonna make it, you know, Japan crazy. And you'll get to see, yeah, there's gonna be something for everyone, I think. And there's gonna, very likely for the hardcore Batman fans, there's gonna be something that's gonna turn them off. But I think everybody should dive into this and ride it to its conclusion, because there's so much. I had no idea this was possible. I guess you sort of hands off with the executive. And you know, if they had tried to manage it, oh, this isn't the Batman brand, we never would have gotten this. It would have been sanitized, or it wouldn't have happened at all. But I'm so glad it did. Because you can have this, and you can have your favorite Batman. We live in that kind of world. Yeah,
they can live side by side.
Yeah.
When they first asked you to do this, what were the thoughts that were going in your head? Like, is it going to work? Is it totally different from what's going on?
My first thoughts were, fuck yeah! obviously I had to... Even when I was first reading the script, when they sent the script, I'm like, I don't think this isn't good. Like, it doesn't make any sense, and I'm not sure what's going on.
Yeah.
And then I went into the recording session, and they were like, here, let us show you some of what we're about to do. And as soon as I saw the visuals, everything clicked. Because anybody who does say, oh, this part didn't make sense, and Batman, you're missing the point. We get this Batman that we've never seen before. And who cares if, I like to call it the MacGuffin engine instead of the Quake engine. Like, it doesn't matter what gets us there. But we got there, and we get this, you know, and we get to take that ride. And then we can go back to, if we didn't like it, we can go back to other Batman. But of course, I'm like, how is this, A, how are they letting us do this? And B, oh my God, you know, the fans are going to lose their shit. In good ways and bad ways, probably. But, I like to do things to shake it up, so I was thrilled. I could not wait to start talking about it, but of course I couldn't. So today, basically. You know, they had sent me a screener that I watched a few days ago, in case the actor doesn't want to sit in the audience, or you know, doesn't have time, or doesn't want to watch it, whatever. I watched it, and that made me even more excited to sit in the room and watch it again, because I needed to know what honest fan reactions would be. And I have to say, I was extremely pleased. Like, everybody was like laughing in the right part. You know, you might think, oh, well, they were laughing at it. But there are parts that are built in there that are obviously meant to, you know, to poke at that. And then just in, you know, that third act battle, when people just started cheering, you know, I was like, that's exactly how it was supposed to go down. I was thrilled.
Well, both your characters come on screen and everyone was plotting in there and going crazy. We were excited to see Red Hood.
Yeah, I loved it. And as I could get this, you know, Red Hood has this line in the, you know, he literally says, well, that was cool. And I was like, that's what the audience is hopefully thinking right now. There were a couple of those moments in there, and I, yeah. Yeah.
You mentioned Elseworlds. Do you have any favorite Elseworlds stories?
Why, yes, I do. The Doom that came to Gotham is like, because I'm a huge Lovecraft fan, and the fan of John Carpenter's The Thing, that is, and Mike Mignola fan, that is one of my favorites. Gotham by Gaslight was another one, and I was lucky enough to work on that, which just came out. If you haven't seen it yet, it's great. It's really good. They did a good job. And it's one of those rated R ones, like Hell to Pay last night. But Yeah, I guess Gaslight and Doom the King of Gotham are probably my two favorite.
Do you like that DC's going more R-rated now because it explores more areas?
I do. I like they've opened that up. I don't think they should just do that. It's like it was, my problem with a lot of the DC movie universe is they're like, oh, Batman was dark, and that, people liked Dark Knight. Let's make everything dark. I think that's the wrong way to go. And so I think, yes, because it's opened up a whole new type of storytelling for the DC universe and these characters. But I don't think we should abandon, the less dark, less gory and, sex-filled and violence-filled ones as well. I mean, there's a huge place for that. Because I still want to watch those. I still want to, do more Batman Limited or, whatever it is. Yeah.
What's your go-to Batman?
Go-to Batman.
Not just film, but like your iteration of Batman. You mentioned Gaslight. Is there one that you just always go back to?
Dark Knight Returns.
Yeah.
Frank Miller's Batman changed my life. When I was reading comics. I mean, and to a lot of us, it did. That is a huge touchstone for me in my life and in the world of Batman. So I would have to say, as much as I love growing up, watching the 60s show, Adam West Batman but what Frank Miller did with Batman in the 80s, I will always go back to that. That was when they changed the game of what kind of stories you could tell with Batman, I think.
Your favorite Batman iteration on screen?
Oh, on screen? Nicholas? No. I would have to say that also because of the time it hit me, the very first Batman film, Tim Burton's Batman film, we've been waiting for a Batman film like that. So that was huge for me. So I think that probably sticks with me. It was funny, we all showed up at the theater, we were all waiting, we had all read The Dark Knight, like it was still living in our heads, and we were hoping that that's the movie we would get, which of course we didn't, but we all showed up with Sons of the Batman painted on our faces, and long coats, and stuff, which you really shouldn't do these days, plastic shotguns, stuff like that, not a good idea.
No.
The world has changed. it was a good time for Batman.
Awesome, thank you.